Just give me a little bit of peace. Steady job and some food to eat. Just give me a little bit of peace. Steady job and some food to eat.
Just give me. He's a former gang member who grew up in a broken family, and he's here to share his story. Ladies and gentlemen, I have Cesar Bronx. What up, man?
How's it going, brother?
I've never actually interviewed someone who grew up on a reservation on my show, so that's why I was definitely looking forward to this conversation. So explain to everyone the name of your reservation. Is it safe to still call it reservation? Is that the proper term?
Yes, that's fine.
Okay, cool. Explain to everyone the name of...
Well, the name is Von Ockham, and it's the size of the Connecticut state. And it is the land that we have, the size of the land we have is actually, we have, is big enough to where it's like part of Mexico and the Sonora, the other side of the border. So we're pretty much like right on the border, and you know, we have both sides of the country, Arizona and Mexico.
Tell everyone what it was like being a teenager on the reservation.
You know, my mom was a single parent and my dad left. You know, growing up, going to school, and at the same time, I started seeing what's going on, like, you know, the drugs, the gangs, and everything else that was involved. And
next to African Americans, Native Americans actually have a much higher percentage of kids who grow up without a father.
Yeah.
Is that that's pretty common on the reservation?
Yeah, it is pretty common because, I mean, like, if you actually, like, it was just most of this. It's not like every kid, but, you know, there are hardly some fathers that are still around, you know, still there, but it's most of us that grew up without a father. Mm.
To the best of your knowledge, do you know when Crips and Bloods started making an appearance on your particular reservation?
I know it's been around, I would say probably in the late 90s or early 90s. It was really kind of like interesting, like not, well, just to know of it, like knowing that we have those gangs there, because I also like, you know, seeing movies and listening to music and, you know, just seeing that, like I really didn't know that was really around, you know.
Now, who are some of the sets, you know, that do you know who some of the first sets to pop up were?
As far as I know, they are the Westside Crips, the South Side Crips, the East Side Mafia Blood, and there's also like different little cliques, the Thug Rider gang, that's a Crip gang, but they also wear green, and there's a couple like the Two Hill Crips, and some are like, and you know, some of these says are kind of like the vicious and well known, such as like the biggest one, the first gang that actually started was the Bloods. They were called the Red Pride Gang. And, you know, that they, you know, they formed themselves as, like, you know, they are natives, but they turn it into, like, themselves, but as Red Pride. You know, they got the name Red and, you know, Pride. They actually were Native Pride boys. I would probably say back in the late 70s or early 80s, there was a group of gangs called, I'm not too sure if it was called the Native or Indian Pride boys, but I know like around the 90s, they changed it to Red Pride Gang, and that's the Blood Gang, and that's the website.
Okay.
And they're still around, they're still active, and you know, I pretty much see like the graffiti as well.
Who has a bigger presence, the Crips or Bloods?
They're pretty much both the same. The culture is well alive and active. And, you know, I know that I get, like, people that go visit out there and they say, like, oh, we didn't really see that much going on. You know, they're there. They're there. They're just, you got to catch them in time. But you will see a lot of graffiti and they're still there.
She said she wanna see the city, but she don't wanna ride the city bus. Because she's new to the town, naive eyes look for truth, the ears are lost in the sound. Brains are lost in the cloud, dead from all of the smoke. That's the reason why the ostrich hides his head in the ground. That's the reason why the monster even puts on a mask. And we turn the city green to blend in with the grass. The city scene made a crash, I fell in love with it twice. Had to tell her goodbye cause she fell in love with the night. I couldn't keep up, I tried to bring her down from the sky. But the clouds were so nice that she took a nap for a while. And when she woke up I finally had a kid and a lady. Bone told me he saw the other day with the baby. Ain't life crazy? I think about it once in a while. When it's cloudy outside and the sun goes. None of these drugs do what they supposed to. Yeah. And what's the point of hurting people that you're close to? Yeah. Most of my life I've been following stars, knowing I ain't really had to go that far. Come to find out it's the truth I already know. Yeah.
I'm spinning out a cylinder, moving, I'm in reverse. Committing crimes of passion, judging jury at first. But I love that girl, been my woman since day one. Had a couple of kids in the house, the job done. So what happened, why we ain't loving no more? Maybe I should take some blame instead of taking the score. But me and more don't go, I'm begging you gotta change. We can work it out even through pleasure and pain. You gotta chill with the liquor, girl, you get too friendly. Who you talking to, baby, that's my man Henry. That's what I'm talking about, baby, just sit your ass. Damn, you wanted to have some fun, me take you out on the town. So you can shake a tail feather, maybe we cut a rug. Drinking and driving on the low key, rumming a jug. Give me a hug, wrong nigga baby. You drive your nigga crazy, in the morning won't remember shit. I know it's kinda hazy.
None of these drugs do what they supposed to. Yeah. And what's the point of hurting people that you're close to? Yeah. Most of my life I've been following stars, knowing I ain't really had to go that far. Come to find out it's the truth I already know. Yeah.
Ready, set, go. Put your seatbelt on, up in the way we bout to go. The road is gon' get windy, promise not to lose control. The final destination's bound to captivate your soul. And so, many MCs inspired to be one of the baddest motherfuckers to touch the MIC. Then the law came life, now your dreams deferred. All the years of writing rhymes captured in a blur. Mind ponders, contemplating the worst. Put all your energy into the music, now you're looking for thirst to be quenched. Paying dues upon dues. Keep on telling yourself I'ma make it. Others believe in you too. And it's true. You can make it if you try. There's levels to everything. Better believe it. Cause you can deny it and never achieve it. It won't come easy. Just put in the work and know your worth. Continue to rise. Cause all we do is capitalize.
None of these drugs do what they supposed to. Yeah. And what's the point of hurting people that you're close to? Yeah. Most of my life I've been following stars, knowing I ain't really had to go that far. Come to find out it's the truth I already know. Yeah. Just give me a little bit of peace. Steady job and some food to eat. Just give me a little bit of peace. Steady job and some food to eat. Just give me a little bit of peace.
I'm curious, do you guys have Sodeño gangs since you're so close to the border? Like, do you have, and obviously Arizona has a big population of Mexicans. Do you guys have a Sodeño presence?
Yes.
Oh, really?
Huh. Yes, we actually do. Talk to me about that. Well, they're kind of hardly around, but, you know, I hardly seen them when I was young. You know, I didn't know what they were. You know, like, I didn't know. Like, I was, you know, as I was kind of, you know, getting, you know, everything when I was young. And, you know, this is when I was six, five or six. This is when everything started hitting me with a lot of things, you know. Mm-hmm. You know, with the gangs and the Soreños. And, you know, I kind of got to know them a little bit because I actually have, I'm not going to mention the names, but I do have like a few families that are in the setting, and, you know, they're kind of telling me, you know, what they do. And I just didn't really like fall into that part with them, you know,
but other than that,
yes. I mean, they're probably still around, but who knows, you know, where they could be at in the reservation.
And this is just me not knowing, so forgive this ignorant question, but is it actual Native Americans that are Soreños, or are they Mexican?
Well, some of these members from the nation, like, we call it, for the members, like our nation, tribal members.
Okay.
Well, actually, like, we have some people that are from Mexico cross, and, you know, sometimes we will get people to actually like stay, you know, they will cross the border, and I never knew that. What I was, I don't know if I was, you know, Mexican or Native, but we do have a lot of tribal members that are half Mexican, because some of their parents have, like, even their dads or moms, they're from Mexico, and they crossed the border, and, you know, some of these guys might have gone with them, and, you know, they started relationship, and, you know, they happen to have kids, and, you know, in our reservation, we do have a lot of half Mexican and Native.
So let's take it back to when you were a teenager. Is that around the time when you started dibbling and dabbling in the streets?
I was hanging out with homies and people that were older than me. I was under the influence, you know, by them, you know. Drinking is one of the big problems on the reservation as well. And that was one of my problems that I had, was drinking as a teen. I was a preteen. I was about to be 13. Mm-hmm. And of course, drugs, marijuana, and, you know, started hanging with the boys, and, you know, they would actually tell me, like, you know, they wanted to test me, like, to see how far will I ever get to, you know, if I actually run into an enemy or someone that will start something with me. Mm-hmm. And they called up somebody, and everybody came, and they said they wanted to set up a big fight for me and someone. So what we did was, we're out to the desert. You know, a couple of people came, cars came, they all went in the round circle, and, all right, they told me, right, let's see what you got. That time, I had to get down and just, you know, fight this person, you know, and, you know, they told me that you're not going to stop until someone lays down. So as I was, and I, to myself, well, my mama was telling me, if anything you go through, do not stop, do not give up. That's what I was trying to do, you know. And, you know, we did our thing, and, you know, I'm not going to say, like, the whole detail. It's like, it was a little drama,
okay,
you know. When we stopped, we, you know, they looked at me and said, all right, I see that you really want to be down for them. So they told me that you're good to go. And, you know, I got to, you know, be rolling with them. And I have a few relatives that were with that too. And, you know, my mom didn't know, you know, she was just out just working. And, you know, and she eventually found out because people were telling her that I was rolling with the wrong people. And, you know, I couldn't do nothing. You know, she just whooped my ass. And, you know, from there on, I just started going, you know, to my grandma's, which is, she lives next door. Started staying with her for a little bit. And, you know, they pretty much, my family kind of knew what I was going through. So they were telling me, you know what's going to come after this, you know. But yeah. You know, and, you know, at that time, I was still rolling with these guys. Part of the homies and my family. And, you know, we got into a couple of fights, this and that. And, you know, I don't really want to get into much of a detail because we do have, like, you know, yeah. I don't want to say names.
Of course.
You know, like,
or dates.
You know,
yeah,
like,
just,
it's,
yeah, be as vague,
yeah,
as you can.
We have a couple of people that passed on from.
I don't want to DJ Vlogy, man. So you.
Yeah.
You feel me?
Yeah, for sure. But that's just what it is, you know. Got into myself, and, you know, I got into it with a couple of people, and of course, I had a knife on me, and, you know, some people saw the fight. I was trying to take off, and the tribal cops came immediately, like about, like, what, 2 minutes, because it was close by the community. And Captain Sue saw me, so they told him what I was wearing. They pulled me over and they arrested me, and they found, you know, a pipe, just like a weed pipe and knife. And I was charged with the weapon and possession of drugs.
Just give me a little bit of peace. Steady job and some food to eat. Just give me a little bit of peace. Steady job and some food to eat. Just give me a little bit of peace.
And does the reservation have, do they have their own, you know, jails and juvie halls and things like that? Or?
Oh, yes.
Oh, okay.
Yes, I went to juvie, yeah. And, you know, like I said, the gang is well known out there. And that was the first thing they asked you when you get into the juvenile. They'll, you know, you get booked in, they'll ask you first, like, oh, do you claim anything? Are you active? And, you know, if you tell them then who you are, then yeah, they're pretty much, they're not going to, like, they're going to separate gangs. They just want to know who you are. They check your tattoos and they'll make sure, like, if you really are that gang. So that way, you know, cause, you know, things happen in, you know, in juvenile, and they put me in a cell by myself first. And, you know, and I had to tell them who I was and where I was from.
Did they put you in an enemy cell or?
No.
Oh, okay.
They put me in a...
Oh, just by yourself, you said.
By myself first, yeah, because, you know, because that was my first time I got charged, you know, getting booked. But I was there for one day. They released me, and they told me to come back to my court day. From there on, I actually had another incident. Like, at that same community, I was hanging out with one of my homeboys there, and he's affiliated with the same gang with me. And we have, like I said, we have our own like community. We have our own building community, and that building. Okay, I got released the next day, came home. What did I do? Went back out outside and hanged out with the homies, and you know, and I was hanging out with the homies, and I think this was like 3-4 more days later. You know, we have a store, a convenience store, not that far. We have to drive. It's like a 5-minute drive, but we actually walked because we had no ride. And you know, we got to the store, and I wasn't 21, but you know, my other homie was. He actually got the beer, you know, came back and said, "All right, let's go." So we started, you know, going back, and we just started chilling at his pad, smoking and drinking and bumping and, you know, just talking. And, you know, we were on the last 40, and he was telling me like, well, I told him that I'm going to go back home and crash. You know, I was getting tired, but he was like, you know what? He's like, we can get a computer and sell that. I know somebody would buy that. And, you know, I was like, really? He's like, yeah, I seen a couple of computers and a couple of things that I really wanted to get. I was like, oh, okay. He's like, yeah, this building over here. It was a white building. It was the white building is pretty much like the community's meeting. This is where they have like the members of the community that come together. Okay. And, you know, they'll have a meeting like on what's going on, what's coming up, you know.
And he wanted to steal computers like from there.
Yeah, he pretty much know what was all in that building, because me, I hardly go in there because there's no reason for me to go in there because I don't know anybody, but he does. My friend does. He actually knows a family member that was working in that building. So we said, all right, well, and you know, us being intoxicated, we're like, okay, let's go. You know, I wasn't feeling myself. I just went with the business, and I wasn't too sure, like I wasn't going to do it because I was too faded to do that. And like, you know, I don't know if I really wanted to run or what, you know, too much. And I told him, when we got to the building, I told him, I was like, you know what? I said, you can do it. I'm going to bounce home. He's like, no, nah, just wait here. So I got it. And then I wasn't going to tell him anything. And as soon as I started walking, two steps, and he broke the window. Yeah. And we pretty much heard the dogs barking. The neighbors were hearing it. And, you know, and we pretty much know that obviously somebody, because it was pretty loud. And we seen a couple of people walking up. And as soon as I saw the people, I started running. And then my friend started running right after me. He was coming too. And I told him that, hey, like, you know, let's split up. Like, you go that way, I'll go this way. And, you know, as soon as, you know, I started like hiding around places, and I couldn't get to my house because I didn't want people to actually see me who I was. And my homeboy, I didn't really know which direction he went. But 5 minutes later, the cops were already there. They were spotlighting, looking, like, circulating around the community. Like, I probably, like, say, like, 3 or 4 times. And I just told myself, like, I got to get home. And I started going around all the way around and just to get to my house. As soon as I got to my house, and I hear the choppers, I hear more police are coming. I was like, damn. And my mom came in. She was heated. She was like, what did you do? I was like, I didn't do nothing. And she was like, well, the cops are looking for you. And I was like, what? And then she said that, who broke the cop window? And I was like, the cop window? And I said, I don't know anything about no cop's windows that's broken. And she was like, well, who did it, they gotta man up. And I was like, what? And then my little brother and my sister were saying that there's cops around the house. And I was like, damn, like, okay. So as soon as I hear more cops coming towards my house, I try to run out the window because I know what I did. I wasn't going to tell that. I wanted to take off. As soon as I jump out the window, then boom, one of the cops caught me, threw me on the ground, pointed the gun at me, and turned me around and handcuffed me, and they took me to the cop car that the window was broken. I didn't know that until they actually told me, well, you know, who broke my window? And I said, well, I don't know. And they told me that it was one of you, the guys that you were with. I was like, yeah, it was probably him, because I know I didn't do it. And then cops came, we have another station department, like it's called the Border Patrol. Mm-hmm. And they're the ones that control the border. And for the tribal police, when they don't have enough officers, they actually call the Border Patrol to come and to, you know, help the tribal police to serve, like, what's going on in the community or protect, you know. So from there, they just charged me with the criminal damaging property. And, you know, of course I had another knife on me. So they charged me with that. And, you know, I went back to juvenile and I didn't get out till like a month later.
Just give me a little bit of peace. Steady job and some food to eat. Just give me a little bit of peace. Steady job and some food to eat. Just give me a little bit of peace.
There's a big problem right now with Mexican cartels teaming up with gang members from your nation, being that they're so close to the border. Can you explain that to the best of your knowledge?
Okay. They actually been around, like, we do get, like, cartels. Like I said, I'm not going to say, like, no names, because I don't want to mention El Chapo.
Yeah.
You know. But, you know, we do get people. Yep. But we know we do get people get that cross. And actually, our reservation, our borderline, is just like a small burial. Like, there's no gate, there's no wall or nothing. It's just like, you know, just jump over it, like
to go from America to Mexico, you mean?
Yeah.
Interesting. Okay.
The Mexican border. Yeah. It's you know, you can, the tribal members, if you're a tribal member from there, you can cross freely as long as you have your tribal ID. Which I do have one, and I can cross freely. If I get stopped by the Border Patrol, I can show them that and they can be okay, you're good to go. And that's what the government laws by the nation goes by, you know, for the tribal members to have. And, you know, in case you want to go to Mexico, and not just Mexico, but you can also, like, have it for, you know, knowing that you're a tribal member from that reservation as well.
Now talk to me about
but everyone else.
Oh, go ahead.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
But everyone else has to have, you know, like full documents, you know, like other nationalities to go through, you know. But the tribal members, they just have to have the tribal ID.
Okay. But yeah, talk to me about the cartels though, and how they're teaming
okay.
up.
Okay. Well, some of these tribal members somehow get connection with them. Well, as far as I know, because we do get like illegal immigrants that come through. You know, of course, they plan to come through. Sometimes they even come with, you know, bales of wheat. And, you know, they just trying to cross and go to their families, you know, not just in Arizona, but they also like can go to California, mm-hmm. to, you know, other states, like who knows where they're going, you know, or try to get to Tucson or Phoenix. And, you know, some of the tribal members there, you know, we help them out too. We give them food, water, you know, make sure they're okay. And, you know, a lot of times that the tribal members will not, they will not like call like the police or the Border Patrol because they don't want to get themselves involved with them, you know, between them and the Border Patrol. So they get what they want. And this is where the drugs start coming in from. You know, when the, you know, the legal immigrants come through, they will have, they will give you like money or they'll give you some weed. Mm. And all they wanted was is some food and water. Mm. And, you know, sometimes they'll start, you know, conversation with them, you know, with the Mexicans and, you know, sometimes they will tell you, well, you want to work with us because we do have stuff that we want to move across to get to wherever they're trying to take it to. And, you know, that's where the business comes in. You know, some of these tribal members actually, you know, they were willing to do whatever they can because it's the money. When they hear that big money, they will do it. There are some members out there that they wouldn't do it because they know the risk and they know where it's going to lead to. Yeah. Personally, with me, I never actually did anything because I didn't want to, you know, mess up or anything like that because some of these guys are serious and, you know, we actually did have a couple of, well, as far as I know, some people are actually like have been murdered when they were working with them because they either stole the money or stole just the bail. And believe it or not, they will come back. Oh yeah. And that was one of the main reasons that I didn't really want to do it. Not because I was going to, but I didn't want to mess up anything, you know. Yeah, that's a good and one. This is where it starts off from them, by them coming through and, you know, and the weed is regular, it's Reggie, and somehow, you know, I seen stuff like that, you know, I'm, like I said, I have a couple of relatives that were involved with this, so I seen like more, like 100 bales of weed. I actually seen bales of weed, you know, since I was a kid, you know, I seen them, you know, when I was a kid too, and, you know, it, to me, it was a lot, like, that was a lot. This is how I know that it was really serious and they were all about their business. And it's just not from wherever I'm at in the community, but it's also everywhere. It's right across the nation border. So there's other tribal members that do stuff like that too. And you know, we actually, people get involved with it, and then we know that there's some gangs that are involved with it as well too. Like we have the gang members that were in it, and you know, like I said, it's been going around. Like it's been going around for a while.
It's just you and me. School is in session, baby, but I don't play. I know you wanted to go to recess, but I take that away. What? Understand I'm the man, even if you had a plan. If you make 200,000, I'm keeping 100 grand.
Wait a minute.
Because I'm pimping you, bitch. This is America, so why not get rich? When you're searching for your music, you're playing my station. I'm two steps beyond, maybe that's the fascination. Come on.
1 + 1 = 2. I'm talking you and me, you talking me and you. When we come together, we be feeling
feeling absolute. We put one in the air and be feeling so cool. Ooh, ooh. I'm a West Coast rapper from the city of the hub. Everywhere I go, I get that California love. Like I'm the plug, they tryna tap into my energy. When I hit the spot, you know I'm coming with that synergy. Replenishing like Gatorade. Got they levels up and now we two steps beyond these lames. Kicking up dust, never running from the smoke. Hold up. We really want the smoke only from Clone God though. Let's go. 1 + 1 = 2. I'm talking you and me, you talking me and you. When we come together, we be feeling absolute. We put one in the air and be feeling so cool.
I'm a Gemini, bitch, so you know what that means. It means that sometime 1 + 1 = 3. I'm a wandering star with 2 grams up in my cigar and a heart with 2 scars. So pardon if I snap, girl, I'm sorry. Bitch, pass me the lighter, I'm about to play Street Fighter. Hadouken that pussy, like my name Ken and Ryu. She says she never kissed a girl, well, bitch, tonight you experiment. Put this tablet on your tongue and just enjoy the experience.
1 + 1 = 2. I'm talking you and me, you talking me and you. When we come together, we be feeling absolute. We put one in the air and be feeling so cool. Ooh, ooh.
Just give me a little bit of peace. Steady job and some food to eat. Just give me a little bit of peace. Steady job and some food to eat. Just give me a little bit of peace.
Being that you guys are so close to the border, you know, I'm assuming that Mexico does bring a significant amount of crime to the reservation. What were, in general, the thoughts of the people on the nation, if you even know this? If you don't, you don't have to answer, but what were the general thoughts of the people on the nation towards Donald Trump's wall?
Oh, okay, yeah. That I can get to. They were not going to let that happen.
Interesting. Talk to me according about that.
According to the nation chairman for our nation. Okay. Well, because this is a sacred land to us, you know, that land's been, that land that we are resided is, you know, it's been for us for a very long time. Like I said, it's sacred. It goes back to history. At that time, way back in, like in the day, they didn't look at it as the border wall or nothing. It was just all like land. Mm-hmm. Sacred. Land.
And then one day somebody came and said, this is the border. And they're like, what the fuck are you talking about?
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. I'm not too sure or don't know much about, you know, the history of, you know, of course. But, you know, the land that we've crossed by, you know, crossing through Mexico has been like freely to us because, like I said, it goes back way back to when there was no border, no kind of border at all. So we were just going through back and forth freely. And, you know, like I said, it's...
They're not going to let it happen? They weren't going to let it happen?
Yeah. Huh. Because, like I said, I mean, we do have families that live on that side.
Gotcha.
We do a lot of things on that side. We actually do, like, traditionally, like, ceremonies. We do, like, we actually do a long walk to the Catholic Church out there, and we celebrate the Day of the Dead, and you know, with all this, it's you know, it's very sacred, and it's a lot to us and the people. And this is one of the things that our traditional, our culture, our history, and the members of our nation, it is dying, it's totally dying. Because I have my grandma saying that it's sad to know that what's going on today, a lot of these young kids are not focusing on our tradition and, you know, everything that we are learning, the language, you know, just about everything because of what the gangs, the drugs, and the alcohol that's in the way for our children and our nation.
Damn, man, I really appreciate you sharing your story. And
you're
a musician also. You go by Caesar Bronx. Tell everybody where they can find you, man.
You can find me pretty much everywhere as the same username, just Caesar Bronx. No space, no caps, nothing.
Yeah, and you're on YouTube, Instagram, all that, right?
Yes. Actually, I'm gonna be actually like coming up, you know, with a lot of music stuff, you know. Right now everything's out just by like messing around, but I have great extended songs, and I don't want to release them because to me, I think they're great. I don't want to release them yet. I just want to wait for the right time. But then they will be out. They will be out this year.
Dope, man. Dope. Well, shit. Whenever you release anything, shoot it my way and I'll play it on my show.
For sure, man. For sure.
You got it.
You know, actually, you know, like I said, I mean, I've been playing a little bit here and there, and I also like trying to work with more artists now. And honestly, I am blessed to like meet a lot of people. And you know, right now I just met up with an artist named Papa J. He was one of my favorite artists like almost a decade ago, and I actually finally got to like work with him. And you know, he's a cool dude, and you know, like I said, I mean, it's all about just work, you know, just processing with them and try to like hang with the business.
That's the main part. Keep that business going, man.
New sustainable development set of goals to end extreme poverty.
The American company sparked a fierce debate across this country tonight. A business in Wisconsin implanting microchips in its employees in the skin of their hands. So what are they tracking, and would you say yes if you were to do the same? Here's ABC's chief business correspondent.
Just give me a little bit of peace. Steady job and some food to eat. I had to rush out of my bed cause I was late for work. My motherfucking rent is due and my boss is a jerk. Pencil pushing at the job, an intermediate clerk. My mama told me to go to school, I'm going bananas berserk. I work every day, don't know where the money goes. My girl is big and pregnant, want me to paint her toes. Only a high school diploma, I'm smelling the aroma. The greenery is burning in my room. But life is a mamacita, she glad to meet ya. She bad coming soon. Better get the broom, my nigga, you clean up your house. You got a little more time to back out, cause she ain't your spouse. But do I love her, I need her, maybe respect how I treat her. But when I see my baby, I'ma wanna go and feed her.
Just give me a little bit of peace. Steady job and some food to eat. Just give me a little bit of peace. Steady job and some food to eat. Just give me a little bit of peace. Steady job and some food to eat. Just give me a little bit of peace. Steady job and some food to eat.
I was born in a space and time where people were stupid. Everybody looking for love, fucking with Cupid. Who did whatever they wanted to do with black fist up? Stand to opposition, keeping Hennessy in a cup. Drink, nigga, tell me what you think about God. The Bible is written by man, so people think of a facade. Form your own opinion before you listen to white men. The system has got you on American Bandstand. And when you get home, you gotta look in the mirror. Take off all the makeup and the wig is more clear. I fear a day when I can't smoke my weed or drink my drink. My nigga, you know what I need. But success is a motherfucker, shoes to fill. I got a baby at home, I need them big time deals. This shit just got real, it's going down tonight. Somebody gon' get jacked, hope they don't put up a fight.
Just give me a little bit of peace. Steady job and some food to eat. Just give me a little bit of peace. Steady job and some food to eat. Just give me a little bit of peace. Steady job and some food to eat. Just give me a little bit of peace. Steady job and some food to eat.
blow that smoke right out your lungs. You go to church every Friday, now you're speaking in tongues. You gave up chilling with friends, pastor got a Benz, repenting on your knees, confessing all your sins to the end. How far will it go? Are you naked, boy? He eating all your candy, tasting your almond joy. Troy, I can help you, let me take you to outer space. If you're looking for God, meditate to the perfect place. Race, we moving at the speed of light, traveling fast through a black hole into my days and night. I'm trying to fight against the norm, my eyes are open, you see, cause I can only be me, not what you want me to be. Classy, nigga born in the 77, daddy named Orlando, my name Kevin, Lucille my mama, the girl True raised me, Kevin and Delilah, they having a baby.
Just give me a little bit of peace, steady job and some food to eat. Just give me a little bit of peace, steady job and some food to eat. Just give me a little bit of peace, steady job and some food to eat. Just give me a little bit of peace, steady job and some food to eat.
Events on Earth are moving in that direction, and really the only solution, if you're on